Hi, I'm John Lennox with Rush Outdoors and the World of Rush Outdoors, and welcome to our series on the basics of planting food plots, brought to you by our good friends at the Whitetail Institute of North America. On today's segment, we're going to talk about pH levels and the importance that pH plays in the long-term sustainability of your food plots. Now, the pH level is going to measure the acidity in your soil and tell you how much, if any, lime you're going to have to use and the amount and type of fertilizer that you're going to want to use. Now, the key here is getting your pH level as close to 7 as you possibly can. Anything under 7 is telling you that your soil is too acidic, but the great news is that the people at the Whitetail Institute can help you determine exactly what you need to get your soil the way you need it. Collecting soil to sample could not be any easier than it is with this simple soil test kit from the Whitetail Institute of North America. Now, when I'm collecting soil samples, I try to do it in a pattern of an X. In other words, I take one from each of the four corners and a few from the middle. Now, you don't have to take a ton of soil, just enough to give an overall look at your food plot. Now, another tip is you want your soil to be as dry as possible when you put it into the soil test kit. So there's nothing wrong with spreading it all out and letting it sit in the sun for a little bit to dry out. Another thing to keep in mind is you're going to want to remove all the debris and stones from that sample so that you're not giving them a lot of stuff to go through. Here's a tip that I think is often overlooked. Your shovel and your bucket have to be as clean as possible. Any residue on your shovel or any sediment in your bucket is going to throw off your test and not provide you with the readings that you need. So take a few minutes and make sure that they're cleaned off before you start the process. So now that you've gone through all of this, you've got your samples, you've got them dried, you've got them cleaned out, all you've got to do is put them into the soil test kit, seal it up, put it in the mail to the Whitetail Institute, and in a few weeks, the results come back. And the best part is, if it comes back and you've got any questions, the pros at the Whitetail Institute of North America are there to help you. For more information on the Whitetail Institute of North America and their products and services, look them up online at www.whitetailinstitute.com. For everyone at Rush Outdoors and the World of Rush Outdoors, I'm John Lennox, and we'll see you in the next segment.